Johnson as your next Detroit City Clerk, the first thing that we need to do is to have the clerk bonded. I am a woman of integrity who has a radio talk show host. I'm a radio talk show host on a show that comes on every Monday and Wednesday from 6:30 to 7 p.m. It's called Stand Up Now. I'm very active in our community. And in this show, every Monday and Wednesday, we talk about and encourage people to be informed, educated, and we showcase people who are doing phenomenal things in the city of Detroit. So this is not new to me. We need people in office as a clerk who is a person, man or woman, with integrity. I can't do anything by myself though. If you have some suggestions for me, sir or ma'am, I'm here for you. And this is my phone number. And of course, we would recruit younger people. We need to go inside of the schools. I'm talking about ones who are even in middle school, in high school, and encourage them to learn about the system, even their parents. If you ask some of them, they don't even know who their city council person is. So yes, we would recruit even those who are in high school. And not just the young people who are in high school, but we need to recruit those family members that all of us have to remember who are a part of our family, and that is those who are with criminal records. They vote. They can vote. The problem is that we have not engaged with the population of our citizens. Remember, our citizens. So no one is going to be left behind when it comes to us voting.
Pray for me. Because after listening to all of this, I just want to cuss. But I'm not.
Oh, go ahead.
Jill Stein, to my knowledge, had dinner with Mr. Putin.
No wonder my machine messed up.
In Russia, having dinner with Mr. Putin. As far as the state of Michigan goes, this is the part that I really want to cuss, but I won't.
No.
We have a governor by the name of Rick Snyder, who has been given permission, to let many of our people in Flint die.
Yeah. Wow.
When I hear the word Rick Snyder, and when I hear the word or the name Mike Duggan, it is one and the same. In 2013, I ain't gonna fall. In 2013, how the hell can, excuse me, don't pray for me. How can a city supposedly with people who are so incompetent, they say, be able to write in Mike Duggan and he be elected? So when the state of Michigan says anything, when the state of Michigan is saying anything about giving our current clerk a pass, let's just be real. There is voter fraud. I may not be able to prove it, but anytime you have a ballot with a signature of Mike Duggan and you have several same signatures with Mike Duggan's name on it, I think that's a little fraud. I do. I was a write-in candidate in November 2011. It just was a fluke. I don't know how it happened, but it just was a fluke that I went to the clerk's office and asked the clerk's office to give me a copy of my voting record. They wanted to write it. I told them, no, you give me the actual list. I was a write-in candidate. There was only two people at my house during that time. My son was counted, but on my record, I wasn't. My vote didn't count. I don't care how many new machines we have. If we don't have people with integrity, and I'm not talking about these people who are just going along just to get along, and folks who look like us, shame on any of you who are just going along hand, and it was returned back to me. Come on now. We have to do better. And it's not just the politician's fault. If we just go along just to get along, it is our fault. My name. And don't y'all forget it. Cynthia A. Johnson. I, as a clerk, would have ongoing training. Cynthia A. Johnson, number one, to make sure that all of the citizens are not left behind. No citizens, including those who have criminal backgrounds. And know this, my door will always be open. First of all, we need to get rid of Janice Winfrey. And I understand that, you know, you're representing Ms. Winfrey because you have a job, and I understand all that too. But anytime you have polling locations where you have polling machines in a location where folks who live at the apartment where the polling machines are, and they can't even vote there, that's a problem. And perhaps the lines were so long other places because where the people were in that apartment where the machines were, they had to leave their apartment to go somewhere else, and now the lines are long. That's crazy. And I'm done. Cynthia A. Johnson, money. I had to break down and buy my own literature. I ain't asking for no money. Why? Because I want to see how you all are going to do your research.
We'll be right back.